A very good morning to you all children. Children, I welcome you all into this session of English grammar. And this is the second class of that. And we are dealing with the chapter, the sentences. Then we have seen that a sentence is a group of words that makes a complete sense. It begins with a capital letter, has a verb, and it can end with a full stop, question mark, or an exclamation mark. Then we had seen also that a sentence has two parts. Part one is a noun or a pronoun part known as the subject, and part two is the verb part called the predicate. Right? And we did some exercises. Now let us move ahead with them. Now this is the new exercise, which says match the column to form complete sentences. Right? Subject and predicate, we have to match the two. The cat. Right? So out of this, which sentence fits in? The best fits in was, it cannot bloom, it cannot score a goal, it cannot tell anything. It gave the dog a bath. Cat can never do that. Was eaten was, oh my god. So the only thing remaining was playing in the train, right? So this, I think, is the correct one. The cat was playing in the rain. Now the doctor always gives an advice, so simply the doctor will be at number C, right? See, the doctor gave us some advice, told me to get some rest. The red flowers bloom in the garden, right? So it's very simple, it's A. Then Inayat and Pema, right? Now there are two persons. See, it can be B also, nobody can eat them. And it can be E also, scored a goal in the final, gave the dog a bath. Now, but there are two persons. If they will score goal, there will be two goals, not one. And it is clearly written, scored a goal, that is one goal. So one person has to be there. Hopefully it will be six. So Inayat and Pema gave the dog a bath. Right, the food in the fridge. Now only two are remaining. The food in the fridge was eaten by us. Just a minute, children. The food in the fridge was eaten by us, and Sachin at the top scored the goal in the final. Right, because single person he will score a one goal. Now see, this is a game which is given, right? Which you can play. In this, you have to make groups of five, make separate sheets of predicates and draw one each. This is something which your teacher shall do. Your teacher will tell the subject and then you will match it with predicates. See, here is a list of things given, right? And whosoever it's correct, you can have to match it. Now, we have to learn something here. We use want or ask to someone to plus base form of the verb to say what we want people to do. I want you to make dinner. Now I, then want, then someone, you, then to, then base form of verb is make dinner. She wants dad to make dinner. I want you to be quiet. Mom wants her to be quiet. With questions, we can use can plus some plus infinitive. See, can you buy some apples, please? Some apples. It's an infinitive. Some apples. Quantity is not there. He asked me to buy some apples. Can you give the cat some water, please? She asked me to give the cat some water. We don't use to in questions. We say please at the end of question to be nicer. This is a sort of decency. Or we say or respect, then, right? Want and ask are verbs, right? I want, can you, then look at the pictures and write sentences. Now see, the first picture is of a dad. See these two. This picture is of Hannah and this picture is of dad. So the sentence is, dad asked Hannah to clean the car, or anything. Now let us do the second one. The first, here this picture is of the teacher and this picture is of Jack and Sally. So you will write, the teacher asked Jack and Sally to play video games. The teacher asked Jack and Sally to play video games. Now we move to the third one. This is the picture of Min and the other picture is of me. Right? Or dad, rather it's of dad. So it will be, see here, this is the picture of Min and this is the picture of dad, right? So Min wanted dad to cook dinner. Sentence will be, Min wanted dad to cook dinner. Okay, then these two, the first picture is of the teacher and the second picture is of me. The teacher wanted me to work harder. The teacher wanted me to work harder. Next two, these two are Jack and Sally and this is me. Jack and Sally asked me to go swimming with them. What is the sentence? Jack and Sally asked me to go swimming with them. Right? Okay. So, I think that ends the chapter. So, let's sum up these things once again, whatever we have learned here. Right? We have learned something about sentences. As we move to the first, it says sentence is a group of words that makes a complete sense. It begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop, question mark, on an exclamation mark. Then we saw that sentence has two parts, part A, which is called subject, having the noun part, and part two, a verb called predicate. Right? Called predicate. Okay, after that we saw want and ask how sentences are formed. Then we ask want plus someone plus two to the base form. And then the example was, I want you to make dinner. Then we ask this, right? Here we did one exercise. I want and I can, right? So I hope you have understood that sentence is a group of words which makes sense. It has two parts, subjects and predicates, right? I hope you enjoyed this session as much as I did in making it. Thank you, children, for your patient hearing.